duties attached to it. Hence, the rights and duties are interrelated and they are the two sides of the same coin. Mahatma Gandhi, father of Indian nation, had said, the true source of right is the duty. If we all discharge our duties, rights will not be far to seek. Fundamental duties strive to create a balance between freedoms of a citizen with its civic obligation in the larger interest of the nation. The incorporation of the fundamental duties in the year 1976 has brought the Indian Constitution in line with Article 29, Section 1 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, which states, everyone has duties to the community in which alone the free and full development of the personality is possible. Rights play an important role not only in individual well-being but also in nation's development. Out of the 11 duties enshrined under the Fundamental Duties Clause 5 of Article 51, Section A of the Constitution of India, on which the event is based today, it specifically states that it shall be the duty of every citizen of India to promote harmony and the spirit of common brotherhood amongst all the people of India, transcending religious, linguistic, and regional or sectional diversities, to renounce practices derogatory to the dignity of women. The duty to promote harmony and the spirit of common goodwill and unity amongst all the people of India essentially flows from the basic value of fraternity enshrined in the preamble of the Indian Constitution. It also urges citizens to renounce practices, customs, and traditions which lowers the dignity of women. Clause 6 of the Fundamental Duties broadly directs the citizen to value and preserve the rich heritage of India's composite culture. India is one of the most diverse countries in the world, and one of the most striking features of India is its unity in diversity. India, being an ancient civilization, is a melting pot of people with diverse religion, cultures, languages, and ethnicity, living together in peace and harmony. India's ancient, unique, and rich culture and civilization values have been a great unifying factor. Today, practically all the religions of the world have its presence in India. This is perhaps due to Indian cultural values, which have abiding faith in tolerance and respect for other cultures. India has always been an attractive destination and has attracted the people of many faiths and cultures who also came to India as invaders, tourists, refugees, seekers of spiritual truth, peace, wisdom, etc. But ultimately they got assimilated into its vast culture, milieu and heritage. For example, St. Thomas, one of the first 12 disciples of Jesus Christ, came to India in 52 AD, was the preacher of Christianity in India. Therefore, Christianity reached India before even reaching to Europe. The Parsis came to India in the 8th century, seeking refuge from religious persecution in Iran and brought Zoroastrianism. And they are still living as a prosperous community of India. The Jews came to India as early as 2000 years ago. Muslims in India form the largest religious group after Hindus. The Buddhists, Sikhs and Jains also enriches the religious diversity of India. The Indian Constitution guarantees freedom of religion to every citizen and to practice and propagate their belief and religion as a fundamental right. And we believe that such guarantees strengthens India. India's policy of tolerance and receptivity has led to the assimilation of plurality of viewpoints, behavior, customs, institutions, and has kept its rich, ancient, unique culture alive. Dr. Mukherjee P.K., one of the pioneers of modern Indian writings, has written that India is a museum of different types, communities, customs, traditions, religions, cultures, beliefs, languages, castes, and social systems. But even after having such a external diversity, none can deny the internal unity of Indian culture. The Constitution of India has created strong and independent democratic institutions like Parliament, Election Commission, and Judiciary, which takes into its ambit the diverse population with equal dignity without any discrimination. The government and the people of India constantly strive towards building of a sovereign, socialist, secular, and a democratic republic guaranteed by the preamble of the Constitution of India. It's a matter of happiness to note that Djibouti also has cultural and ethnic diversity. We understand that the Constitution of Djibouti, like the Constitution of India, weaves together the diverse, multilingual, multi-ethnic, multicultural populace, forming a healthy, harmonious unity. Djibouti, like India, has also experienced colonial rule. There is a constant immigration from neighboring countries. This experience of interaction and intermingling of diverse cultures has given birth to a composite culture, which is a very tolerant culture. A diverse population in a country brings multiplicity of perspectives and worldviews and provides a broad range of cultural, philosophical, and intellectual inputs, thereby enriching the overall cultural heritage of a country. Djibouti is a shining example of a peaceful, tolerant society living in harmony with diverse ethnic groups and nationalities, which bring peace and prosperity to the country. In the end, I hope that in the future, the citizens of both countries, under the guidance of fundamental duties, would play a more active and bigger role in the development of their respective countries and become a source of inspiration for others to follow. Thank you.